Welcome to session number two of Wild West Werewolf, The Quickening. This episode starts with Achachak tells it true and pins the hair. In the forest, sort of near the trail that leads into the sept, and they are like in the underbrush, pins the hairs in lupus form, and they have summoned a spirit of a raccoon that Achachak wishes to converse with. Pins the hair, just kind of is slouched forward with like his butt up in the air, staring down this raccoon spirit while Achachak does his thing. So the raccoon spirit is basically sitting on a log, and like he's looking at you. He's all luminous and silvery blue, and kind of like tilts his head. He's just like, staring at you.
I present a small box like this big, and I set it down. And like, there's a key that's been like broken off in the lock to make the lock unopenable. It's kind of like, unless you bash it open. Uh-huh. But I set it down in front of the raccoon. And I'll, like, glance into his eyes with, like, reverence. And I'll say, great raccoon spirit, I have brought this offering to you in hopes that you would teach me your tricks, your gifts, so that nothing can be barred from me, nothing locked, just as it is not barred from you. And I'll, like, push the box towards him.
And the raccoon spirit will, like, look over at Pins the Hair, and Pins the Hair will lock eyes for him for a second. And then Pins the Hair turns his head back to you, says to you in the mother's tongue, he'll be like, raccoon spirit, say, he will teach you to open box, but until the next full eye of Gaia in the sky, you must leave hardtack in this spot once a week.
I nod.
Alright. The raccoon spirit like kind of like shuffles up your shoulder, like is sitting on your shoulder. Mm-hmm. And he like puts an arm, like a little raccoony arm, and you can feel it around your head. He points at the box, and then he takes both of his hands and goes like smashing, like in a smashing motion.
I pick up the box, one hand on each side, and I'll like shake it first, and then do the smash motion.
All right, roll gnosis.
Here's my big dice pool. Can I spend willpower on gnosis rolls or no?
No, I don't think so. Maybe.
Right,
you
here
can.
We go.
Can you?
Oh, hey, I did good. I did good. I rolled already.
It was difficulty 6. So you only need one success. You fucking smash the box on the floor a couple of times, and pops open, and inside is a rolled up piece of paper.
I snatch it up, glance at the raccoon, and like unfurl it.
The raccoon spirit kind of like runs off your shoulder and like starts sniffing around the box, and then looks at something in the bushes and like runs off. But the scroll, or like the piece of paper when you unscroll it or whatever, is it's like written in English. I don't know if you would exactly understand what it is, but it's like a long, like written in English thing with weird like scrawling at the bottom.
I know someone who I hope speaks English, so I'll close it back up again. And do I get any? Does it feel different that I know how to open boxes now?
Yeah, like when you felt like you might have been able to bash this box open if you tried hard enough. Mm-hmm. But you basically like,
I willed
you
it.
You wrapped it like twice, willed it to be open, and you felt like just like a spiritual energy, I guess, go through your JO crystal,
sweet,
and like into
sweet.
Your heart, and now you know like that feeling. If you try to do that shit again, you'll probably be able to do it.
I'll look at Pins the Hare and give him a very courteous nod. And in the native tongue, I'll thank him.
Oh, he'll kind of like scratch his chin for a minute. Or he's in his wolf form. So he just like scratches his back of his ear, I guess, with his paw. And says back to you in high tongue, like, "Oh, think nothing of it, brother. I would make sure to heed your promise to the raccoon spirit."
I will. Mahan, mahan. And I head off to Donnie, who I hope can read English.
Alright, and at this point, when you and Pins the Hare, like, go your separate ways through the woods, another Garou approaches the sept. And PJ, you know that you're getting close to the sept. You can smell, like, the campfires, and you can smell other Garou and kinfolk not too far from where you are.
Okay. I'll, like, give an alert Hal that I'm here, like an introduction.
Okay. So go ahead and give your howl of introduction.
You know, it's a long howl from a red wolf, and in the mother speak, it kind of, it comes out to from the Cheyenne. I am Pins, or I am Chases the Storm, Arun, come to fight the worm, and learn to bond with your brethren.
All right, there's a few howls that, like, take up, you know, they get really loud or whatever, but the one that's, like, the loudest of all is from some kind of she-wolf, and it says to come to the moot rock inside the canyon. It's given by the alpha of the sept, cracks the canyon. She's a Croatan and an elder.
Okay, well, I will follow that howl.
All right.
And so, I will, I guess, like, run by my buddy.
Which buddy?
A check.
Oh, yeah, yeah. At your check, as you're making your way back towards the sept, you see, you can describe whatever you look like, Peach.
I look a lot like my picture from what you... I mean, there's not a whole lot of my picture, obviously, but I am a fairly large red wolf with a thick, bushy tail that kind of has a serene presence about him. He's in lupus form, so, you know, he can't tell that he really has, you know, any items or anything, but they're... is a scar that runs down his side.
Do you have any discernible pure breed?
Yes, I do. I have pure breed 4.
4?
Oak 10. And I think me and Ziggy worked out that we were in the same den previously.
Oh, yeah, yeah, so you know you do. All right. So when you move past me, I'll raise a hand in greeting, and I'll say in like the wolf tongue or the Garou tongue, "Greetings, my friend. I'm about to go to the residence of McCormack."
The wolf will bob its head. Must go to Moot Rock. After, we'll find McCormick.
I nod to you.
And,
there's
scamper.
Another wolf there, I guess, close by, because it's happened very close to when we were just doing our thing. It's got, like, a little bit of Wendigo pure breed, another lupus. It's like a bluish gray looking wolf right there. Comes up and like sits near you guys looks at the new guy, says, pins the hair, Wendigo, the urge, Cleath, will take you to Mootruck, no quickest way, not past white man.
I say good, and just we'll move to follow him.
Alright. So basically he takes you, and I don't know if Atchachek's going straight to McCormack or not.
Yeah, if Pins the Hair is picking him up, I've already been to the Moot Rock, so I'll say, I'll hold up this piece of paper and kind of wiggle it a little. And I will say, curiosity sends me to McCormack.
We'll meet you soon.
Why not? We'll rendezvous at the rock.
I do not know this word. And they run away. Or he runs, he starts to run.
Good.
I follow.
I go to McCormack.
Alright. I don't have the picture on this computer, but basically Pins the Hair takes you to the Moot Rock, where there is just one old Native American lady with, like, big skin blankets wrapped around her. She's got, like, a headdress on, and she looks as if she's made of, like, cracked clay. She's fucking super old and, like, sun-weathered. And she kind of, like, grins at you with not showing teeth, but just, like, a welcoming old lady smile. And, like, motions for you to come closer. Come closer, child, grandchild. These eyes are not what they used to be. Come to the fire.
I will slowly approach in like kind of deference to her, like I keep my head bowed down a little bit and walk up slowly.
Pins the Hair will follow you. She has some fish on a stick over some fire. And she's already like eating one of the fish, and she waves a hand in front of it like, you have traveled far. Are you hungry?
Don't like burnt meat.
Well, I understand. I understand. There's plentiful hunting in the woods where you came from. She points. I'm sure that you are able to fend for yourself. It would be more to your liking. I have developed a taste for burnt meat. You are the denmate of Tells It True, yes?
Yes.
It is a joyous day that more of our brothers arrive in this sept. So many faces from across the sea. It is good to see a homegrown warrior.
Yes. I fight good.
Yes, yes, you fight good. And perhaps one day you will be able to fight alongside our warden, Ultimatum. And Pins the Hair kind of like his ears drop back after she says that name. Well, the moot is not for another few days, so I will not keep you any longer, chases the storm. Feel free to hunt and, go where you please. Be mindful that, the Europeans have odd customs. Different than even the Hamid kinfolk you may have encountered. If these types of things offend you, I would suggest sticking to the northern part of the sept. And she points across the canyon to the other side. Over there are where the Red Talons reside. They are quite territorial, but not so much to your kind, as I'm sure you know. You may go now, unless there is anything you wish to ask me.
No.
Very good.
He'll turn to Pins the Hare. Oh. You hunt? I'm told to sit sideways.
Yes, hunt, but first McCormick.
McCormick.
She says, Pins, dear, please show him the safe hunting trails where the hunters from Harder's Field do not travel. Any kind of like, I don't know, whatever the wolf equivalent of a thumbs up is, and he stands up. Follow me if you are ready.
Go.
All right. So you guys take off back towards the forest, and you could probably hear like the pitter patter of a bunch of like barefooted redhead children as you approach the McCormick stead where Ashachak and Donnie McCormick are already, you know, doing their thing.
So, because I'm native, I don't want to get shot. So, like, I'd be on the outside of his residence, mm-hmm. hoping that his kids would inform him that I was there.
Yeah. All right, so, well, Donnie, one of your son, right. Seamus, your son Seamus, comes running up to you. He goes, Papa, get the gun. There's a dirty red savage over there. And he points over at
him. Alright, so I pull out my my deer hunting rifle, and I fire a warning shot at him. What have you been doing there? You best be turning around, because we don't go into no strangers around here.
I shout loudly in my Indian accent, McCormack! Nahai, nahai!
Tim. Seamus, go in and gather up little Bridget and Aaron and get him in the house. I don't want this man to see me daughters.
Oh, right away, Papa. Don't let the dirty savages get the daughters. And he, like, goes and come on, you fucking lumpheads. Go on inside. And he rounds up your other children, and they head inside the thing, and you can see all of their little heads sticking up by the window. That looks like a cell phone reception signal.
It's got like those like little shutters that have little crosses in them, you know, that they used to make in the Old West. So I like shut them all and batten them down.
There's like a groan from inside.
He's probably like sitting there. All right now, Seamus, remember. Keep cover me, like I told you. It's like a little 4-year-old boy. He's got a big gun. And I'll go out there and meet him. Like, I'm basically... I'm like, since I gave the gun to Seamus, I'll just go out there, and I'm carrying, like, a mug that's, like, sort of empty. That's all I've got in my hand.
I glance at the mug and remember... last night, and my stomach just naturally turns. But I place one hand on it and the other hand on the paper and kind of gesture to you. McCormack.
Itchy Chalk, what you doing here?
I try to hand it to you. And I just my eyes.
I kind of, as you, like, just kind of pause at me, I, like, naturally step back, like, whey!
I open it and show you the English words, and do a. All right.
I imagine I probably know at least a little bit of English.
Yeah, you know enough to like get the gist of this. This is a deed to a plot of land.
Hoy, what's that there then? It's a place. Oh, It's a piece of paper that says some white man owns it. What you been doing? You been scalping some people out there, Itchy Chuck?
I grin and give you a half shrug and tap my chest and reach for the paper.
Hey, it's not me and mine. Maybe we should go out there and see, we should go into town. Oh, that's right, you can't. And see where the heck this deed is. We'll go to the land office.
Aye. McCormack.
Where the heck is that, big mangy Swede that was with you? Guy that doesn't know how to go into the fucking dock when somebody's shooting at him.
When you talk about the big, shaggy Swede, there's like a low wolf howl in the mother's tongue that says, pins the hair, McCormack. Do not fire stick.
Hey, everyone's come a-calling today. I don't know what. Did I come into some money? That's usually when people come around here, you know? When they come into a little bit of money, they all come here wanting a piece of it. But I don't remember coming into any money. I'll howl back. In, like, with my little lilting Hamid voice. To meet me at the, and I will, like, head out. Are we, like, on the Bon, or are we, is my, like, homestead on the Bon, or is it, like
just closer? On the outside.
I tell him to meet me on the Bon, right. Like, near a big tree or something that I know, a bunch of wolves would recognize.
Okay. So, yeah, he's gonna come meet you by a big old oak tree or something.
Alright. Come at you, Chuck. We got to go meet Pins the Hare. I'm sure you heard him.
Alright, so Chases the Storm. Pins the Hare is going to lead you to this oak tree. And then he's going to shift up into Hamid. And he looks at you and says in Mother's Tongue, for their comfort, you don't have to.
I'm sorry, I lagged out for a second. What's going on?
I'm leading you to a tree, and then I'm shifting into Hamid and saying that you don't have to do it. I'm just doing it for those guys' comfort.
Okay, I nod. I don't shift.
Alright. Yeah, you guys get there whenever you get there. You can totally get there right now if you want.
Alright. Yeah, so I'm, like, running out, like, kind of just, like, in my, like, freaking leather stocking breeches, like, pioneer clothing.
Alright, right on. He's sitting there, I'm trying to find a picture. But, he's sitting there with, like, just his, like, deerskin tunic and pants, and he's got, like, a bow. And he's just kind of, like, leaning up against the tree with a big red wolf next to him.
I'll gesture to Chases the Storm, and in the wolf tongue I'll say, this Chases Storm, broodmate to Adichuk.
I pointed the red-haired guy and look at Chases the Storm and go McCormack.
So pretty much just look like the picture, wearing like some basically just frontier garb, buckskin pants, a big one of those big like floppy shirts, probably no hat. Because I was in the woods and it's all shady. I'm a little bit sunburned because I'm Irish, and it's very sunny here. and freckles all over, of course. Oh, hey, so, what you been wanting? Is this, official business you've been calling me for?
No. I was looking for Brother Achachak. Said he was coming here. Told Chase's storm would bring to McCormack. Brought to McCormack. Well, Chase, brought McCormack here.
Chase's storm says, you hunt?
Boy, I'm not hungry right now. I just ate. I don't know about this itchy truck here, but he was like curious about some paper that he needed me to read for him. And I did it, of course, just to be sociable.
I look at Chases the Storm. My point to Achachak. Found human glyphs. Can't read. McCormack can read.
Chases the Storm, snorts, and says, read.
And, yeah, pins the hair, kind of, like, laughs a little bit. Terrible. And he says to you in, like, mother's tongue, even though he, like, forgets that these guys speak it as well. Hamid's short memory. Have to record things on things.
This great paper, I gestured towards the paper. Deed for land. Very important.
What is deed? Deed, like, pins the hair?
White man, have land on paper.
How white man live on paper?
He
gets, like, really close to it and starts to, like, put his face near the paper looking for white men.
Not having a complete understanding of how this works, I'll gesture to the tree we're in front of, and I'll say, if paper says tree is of McCormack, then tree belong to McCormack, and Achachak cannot cut down tree.
Paper does not decide who has land.
Wait. I think I understand. I mean, like, he reaches out. May I see paper shortly?
Yeah. Here you go.
Okay, he takes it and he sniffs it. And then he hands it back to Achachak and he goes over to the tree. And he, like, sniffs the tree. And then he gets lower and sniffs the bottom of the tree. And then he, like, shimmies up a little bit and sniffs the tree some more and slides down. Paper not for tree. Paper not smell like tree. Deed, whatever smells like deed, is property of owner of deed. Yes?
I'll glance over to McCormack.
Well, I don't know. All this deeds and stuff, that's all like some sort of thing the English try to foist on us to run us off. That's all I know. And I'll, like, raise my pewter mug and take a big old swig of whatever's left in it.
And
they come around the papers all the time, the damn English, telling us to get off because they own it, even though me and me pa and, like, my grandpa and my grandpa's grandpa had lived there for thousands of years. That's all I know.
Pins will look back at Chases a Storm. Thought I understood. Do not understand. Why not just pee on property? Then everyone knows. Why need paper?
I'll break a smile.
The best way I can do to explain it is, these English fellas, and Germans too, they're all daft cunts. But what they do is they have a place they've already peed on, and then they pee on the paper, and I point to the ink. And that kind of, so they can go around and tell everybody that, like, the place that's, like, that they peed on smells like the paper, so it's theirs. It's kind of hard to explain.
Paper no protect white man from my teeth.
I'll kneel down closer to you. And I'll say, chase the storm. They said at Great Rock that we must live together, and I'll make this hand gesture, with Wormbringers, with White Man, and White Tribes.
Wormbringers, well, insult after check.
I nod, but I don't look apologetic at all.
Word.
If White Man say, my land, his land, because he have paper, it not protect him. It not make him, my land his land.
Maybe if White Man wrap many paper, bangs cannot go all the way through. And he like points to his arm and like does like a wrapping motion.
Boy, if I'm going to listen to this conversation any longer, I think I'm going to have to go back for another point.
By the way, Thorfinn, you heard just very shortly ago a lot of different like people in Mother's Tongue going, McCormack! And then gunshots.
So I guess I'm out wandering or whatever.
You are somewhere in the sept, yeah.
Yeah.
You could be doing whatever you want. If you want to jerk it under a tree, that is nature.
As is Viking tradition, I was jerking it under a tree. No. he was just, you know, taking a lay of the land, as he's new to this continent to begin with. And as he walks out of the bushes to see whatever the fuck is going on.
I'm going to roll a Perception Primal Urge. And since I'm in Hamid, I guess it would probably be harder.
So you wouldn't get the normal bonus.
Right. Okay.
I think instead of harder, it should still be Diff 6. It's just if you're in Lupus, it should be lower because you have better snout. All right.
Fair enough. Okay. I get plenty of successes. 4. So, pins the hair, just kind of turns his head towards where Thorfinn is, like, coming from. And he'll point, he'll say, McCormack, no fire stick. White Man. Smells like Thorfinn.
And I guess that's to say that Thorfinn will exit the bushes, and for those who have not seen Thorfinn, you would see blonde-haired, white-skinned, almost, you know, to the point of being, like, ice-skinned white man with long blonde hair, a beard, and ice, palest ice. He's obviously from those who have seen that, some purebred Yennefenris type of person. And it looks to each one of you, nods to the one he knows, and looks to the small, small wolf that is not seen before.
I mean, for wolf sizes, he's a pretty stocky wolf, but,
I think Thorfinn's, like, huge, or Thorfinn, I mean.
Right, he's bigger than the normal man. He's big in every aspect.
Right on. Chases a storm will, kind of nudge into his den mate. And he will ask, how know if white man good? Some bad, some good.
I'll nod down to you and glancing back at these guys and then back towards you, I'll say in like I guess I'll use Mother's Tongue still as we're speaking. I'll say, there are some good and some bad, but we must obey words of elders and not cause hostility. There is tribe of red wolves that is looked upon with suspicion because they do just as you suggest. We must be bringers of unity.
Pinsayer's going to pop up to his feet and go over to Thorfinn. And just like, unless you stop me, of course, he goes and he puts his hands, like, up on your shoulders, and then he, like, if you have any hair over your neck, he moves it and points to the scar where he took that 45 slug in the neck. And he says, white man, get hurt, saving cub. White man, save cub anyway.
This white good, other white bad,
many
no white tell. Many white bad, just only fight if shot at?
White man guru good, usually. Better than white man with no wolf blood. Understands Gaia.
Should fight if get shot?
Yes.
Oh.
But do not eat.
No.
Learned that one hard way.
Oi. I don't know, as long as you keep to the litany, I figure you're all good. That's what I always been told back in my sept, back in good old Wheeler, Virginia.
Yes, white man who follow litany, good. White man guru, usually good. Sometimes bad. If shot, fight back. But do not kill white man in night. Unless shot. Or unless smell like worm. If smell like worm, destroy.
That is duty.
Yes, but take pleasure in destroying white men who smell like worm. This one.
Yes. Is my family's destiny. We find the worm and root it or remove it. Uktena good at binding worm to earth and guarding dark places.
Uktena good. Uktena brother. Uktena oldest brother. Wendigo youngest brother.
And he'll give like a short howl bark thing.
I will do the same.
So, what we doing here?
Hunt.
Yes, hunt. McCormick, read paper. Paper, smell like black pea. Black pea mean own land. If smell like black pea also.
Don't know what land is.
Yes.
Well, that's why... Well, they've got something in a town. It's called the deed office, where they like to try to get you to give you all their money for the land. I don't know. They call it taxes. It seems right unfair to me. That's why I never pay them.
Deed office will show where land is.
Where the, yeah, well, you know, they got the guy in there. He looks up a book of mini papers, and then where that is, there's like they got another piece of paper called a map, and that shows you where it is. It's kind of hard to explain to, especially to you wolf folk. But it's like a tool that the Homans use. Well, I don't know if I don't know if your friend here knows what a map is.
Know what map is? We hunt. And then pins the hair, like, reverts back to Lupus Worm. Chases Storm. You, Arun, you lead hunt.
Yes.
So if you want, PJ, give me, like, a perception survival. Or primal urge, whichever one's higher.
Okay. I'll just do perception survival, which is 5 dice for me.
Do the same.
But I'll also activate heightened senses for tracking and stuff.
Alright.
So it's down diff.
Also, you're in wolf form, so it's lower anyway. So cool. Diff 4, I guess.
Well, heightened senses lowers it by 2, so.
Also, diff 3.
Yeah. But it doesn't matter for this roll. But. Yeah, tell me what we doing. What I find.
How many successes did you get?
You rolled for me, right?
Oh, no, I rolled for me.
Oh, okay. Roll me 5 dice, please.
I don't know. Is this like are we all hunting, or is this like just like
me and him are like hunt? Me and him are running off to hunt. If you want to join us, you know, feel free. But,
is there like a meeting spot that we all got, or did the elders tell you guys to meet back up at the rock or no?
Yeah, I think so.
No, they didn't say anything about that. But okay. If you want us to come meet at the rock, you can howl that at us as we're running away. We'll bring you back some food. We know that you guys can hunt.
We'll.
I'll howl that.
Okay, sure. So when we're done with the hunt, we'll all meet at the rock. You guys can do what you're doing while we...
I don't think I can go into town because I'm a native right now. Look odd if a native suddenly shows up with, like, a deed. So I'll pass the deed on to Thorfinn. And I will say, you and McCormack in town see where Field is. And what is on this field?
He'll nod and kind of pat the back of McCormack. You got time?
Well, I was planning on teaching me youngest to shoot today, but I guess we can swing into town and have a point.
Aye. Sounds mighty good.
Alright, things I do.
You're able.
So yeah, I got what, 5 successes?
Yeah. So you're able to excuse me. Sorry.
No problem.
you're able to locate like 3 deer. I mean there's like more of them, but you're able to like with pins the hair get 3 deer separated on the run. So now I want a Dex Athletics to run them down.
Okay. That's fine. If you could roll that for me, that will be 8 dice.
Right on. Oh, you got 2 successes.
All the ones.
Yeah. Shut up. But that's enough. So you're able to, like, run down your deer and,
time out. Doesn't Lupus Form actually give me some bonus dice or something? Yeah.
I don't know.
Lupus gives me 2 more decks.
Okay.
Okay.
So you got 3. So you're easily able to run down your deer. Now my roll for me. I got... 4.
Cool.
Alright, so we each are able to pick off like the 2 biggest deer. The third one kind of like scampers off into the woods, unless you're going to go after that one after you killed the first one.
No, I'm not greedy. I think me and you can probably just eat on one and then bring another one back.
Word. All right, so I'll just drag mine back with us by its neck.
Cool.
I got a mouthful of deer. Meat back, moot rock. Feed stupid white men can't hunt.
And there's just grunts and pulling his deer back as well.
All right, so actually, you know what? Let me roll a fate die. You don't want... I'm rolling a d6. We don't want a 6.
Okay.
We didn't get a 6. All right. So we get back to camp easily enough. And as we start, getting back towards the sept, our path is shadowed by a really tall... dude dressed in a black duster, black or dark blue, navy blue military union shit, and a big gray Confederate cavalry guy hat. He's got long hair and a beard and eyes that are gray and have really tiny pupils and are really piercing, and he just stands blocking our way, specifically in front of you.
Okay, I will keep pulling it until I get close to him and then drop it out of the mouth and just kind of lock eyes and stare at him.
He says, Ah! You boys going somewhere with fresh kill, not giving what is due to Alpha?
I look at, it kind of looks sideways at Pins the Hair.
Pins the Hair kind of drops his deer, pushes it towards the guy, and the guy reaches down with clawed fingertips and pulls a little piece off the deer and eats it, and then he's like, "Yes, Pins the Hair. I know you are submissive, Omega, but this one, I want his deer."
You Alpha?
I am your Alpha.
Alpha is strong, doesn't need to puff chest.
Exactly. And he reaches down to grab the deer.
I am gonna push my nose against his hand and be like, "No."
He looks down at you, he says, "You are not high enough in station to challenge me. Give me my due. I eat first from this carcass." And Pins the Hair kind of starts whining. And he whines low in a low voice to you, "Ultimatum."
I will bite the lower part of the leg on the thing and worry the bone and try to break off a piece of the lean, not good leg piece and spit it at him.
All right, roll a strength roll first.
Okay. I believe that is also 8 dice for me.
All right. Nice. You got any specialties?
No.
All right. You got...
I always forget to get specialties when I make my characters.
You can add them in later then. You got 6 successes. So you basically just ripped the entire leg off this thing and flick it up at him, and he catches it by the hoof. "Very well. Move along, boys." And he just walks away. He's a human, but he's got a full deer leg, and he's just chomping on it. and walks away, like kind of whistling a tune.
Okay. I grab the leg and pull it.
Thought you were going to die. Ultimatum. He looks around. Bad white man.
Why lead a rune?
Strong. Strongest rune. Also, lead white man in treaty was in white man army kill many pure one before truce. Kill many pure one before truce. Now work with Alpha for truce. Alpha, forgive.
His hackles raise.
Middle brother, forgiving. Not understand either.
I'll just put the deer leg back in his mouth, and he seems like in a less good mood. Like his ears are kind of laid back, and he's just kind of like dragging it and.
Same thing with Pins the Hair. So in the while that was happening, what were you guys doing?
I guess we're gonna leave Ichichuk to like fuck off in the woods or something while we go into town.
All right. So Ichichuk, what are you doing?
Basically fucking off in the woods. you headed to the stone in a casual walking pace.
Alright, roll a perception alertness for me, actually.
Holy shit.
Three successes. Right.
So as you're walking through the web, you fucked off in the woods, and you're like walking towards the moon rock, you smell something weird, and like, you look down at the base of this mighty oak tree, and there's like this pool of like weird pearl colored jam and like a sack, and the sack is tipped over, and there's a bunch of like crustaceans that have been cracked open, and the meat has been like removed, and just all around the base of this tree is this weird like whitish liquid.
Remind me again what the raccoon wanted from me?
He wanted, hardtack biscuits. What?
Okay, he wanted biscuits, okay. So, I'm looking at this stuff. Can I roll anything to figure out what this thing is?
Yeah, roll said, like a...
Kneel down to study it?
Yeah, roll like a perception primal urge.
Right.
Or perception survival, whichever one's higher.
Primal urge.
So heat powerful voodoo make crystal glow.
Yeah, so like at first you get like this scent of protein, and then you realize like, oh, I've smelled this before. This smells like humans mating, but also like the meat from like this, what are they called, these weird little crustaceans that like are at the bottom of lakes with little pinchers on their hands, crabs. It's like crab meat and, like, the remnants of a J.O.
I take note of the tree, the location of it. I do, like, a full 360 to see if there's, like, a trail, like, a path that people would have taken probably to get to here.
There's no path. You're, like, you're pretty deep in the woods, but you know, based on, like, your knowledge of the sept, when you look around, that you're deep in get territory.
Okay. I hurry my way through it. All then right. I'll take note of where this tree is.
Okay. You make a mental note of the J-Oak.
The J-Oak.
Alright, so Thorfinn and fucking McCreary, or whatever your name is. McCormick. Yeah, you make your way into town. You're, like, but right behind the Fianna Bar, and town is out in front of you. There's, like, the saloon, there's the animal pens, and the livery place you were at yesterday. There's a couple of different shops, a general store, a blacksmith. Actually, not too far off from you, there's, like, a big black wooden caravan, and there's some dude in a black suit with a top hat and a cane, standing on a soapbox, holding a green glass bottle and waving it at the passersby while he yells things. And off to the northeast, there's a you can see like the outline of the fort, the U.S. Army fort that's been put up there a while ago.
Okay, I guess I'll go into the Fianna Bar and ask the kinfolk there where the deed office is.
Okay, so like you open the door and there's three of them chilling in there. The guy you talked to yesterday, he was the bartender, is like, "Ah, Donnie, what can I do for you? My favorite customer."
Hey, Fergus. Well, I was in town, so I thought I'd nip in and see what's happening with the family.
Oh, you know, Donnie, we're doing good, keeping the locals knee deep in booze and poon.
Oh, hey, that's what makes them happy.
Aye. What can I do for you, Donnie? And he like tosses you a bottle.
I'd take it, like pull the cork out with my teeth, and like take a big swig and pass it back. I was wondering. Go ahead.
Oh, it's like white lightning.
That's some fine mild stuff you got there.
Aye, we were saving it for Finnegan's wake, but we figure, fuck it, Donnie's our favorite customer.
Aye. So I was wondering, I was in town and I found like some things in there, and I'm wondering where's the deed office in this here little burg of yours?
They look at each other and they start cracking up. Deed office. Have you not heard of the Homestead Act? You just kind of go and tie your bandana around a fucking stick.
They gotta have a place where, like, you freaking file your claim, don't you? I know how these English do things. The way they did it back home.
All the fucking right. He just takes a big swig. Goddamn fucking dirty Brits. But anyway, any kind of legal things or things regarding property usually go through the sheriff. I think he might be, he's probably in. He's probably stinking drunk. But he's probably in. If not, his deputy could help you. Lad by the name of Barney.
Hey, he a good Irishman? Or is he,
I think he's mixed. He's some kind of, I think he might be mixed with Injun, but, you know, who knows? He's a real skittish type. Barely any chin, big eyes.
I guess we'll go and meet this guy, Barney. Come on, Thorfinn, let's go. I stick the cork like back in the bottle with my teeth.
Mm-hmm.
Hand it back to him and give him like a big old smile and a wink.
Oh, you're a saint, dummy. Drinks the rest of it in one swig. And then as you, like, leave the saloon and the doors like, flap close, you just hear him, "Whoo!" Because he's instantly trashed.
Sweet.
Alright, so walking through
slight
town.
Buzz.
You're walking through town with a slight buzz on. And both of you make a perception alertness.
By the way, Jake, was it the sheriff and stuff like that that really wanted me to join the fucking army?
Yes.
Cool.
Two successes.
Alright. You both hear this weird kind of like high-pitched giggling. but you can't place where it's coming from.
It's still daytime though, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Alright. I look around, not seeing like who's laughing at me, and I just shrug it off, I guess, and head on to the sheriff's office.
Okay, so you like head past the saloon, and there's like some hookers out on the porch, fanning themselves and drinking fucking Tom Collins's, and one of them waves over at Thorfinn, and she's like, "Hey there, big boy."
And he's going to look them up and down. Notice that not anything in the likes of the Scandinavian women caliber, and kind of just scoff and continue walking on.
It's like, ooh, we don't get many big, tall, blonde, blue-eyed men around here. I'd be willing to give you a full moon special. And she winks at you.
He'll just shake his head. And whisper, like, beneath his breath to his good old friend Donnie, "Are all new country women like these, flaunting themselves?"
Yeah, that's right, sweetheart. Just walk away. Talk to your boyfriend. Probably an inbred.
Oh, boy. Well, these girls are whores. These girls are whores, Thorfinn. Like, you know, if you want some time with them, you gotta pay for it. Not that like you, not like regular women, you don't have to pay for it, but with them, you do it all at once. With other girls, you do it a little bit at a time.
So you just don't sweep them off their legs, like in the olden countries. In the olden countries, you just took
all right, well,
you couldn't sweep a floor, sweetheart. Get on out of here.
Never mind.
Looks like he's been riding all day with a corn cob in his saddle.
Oh, I don't know that. You ain't my type. Not related to me.
They just, like, stop talking to you guys at that point.
I grin. Like, and let, like, a little bit of, like, my rage show as I grin at them. Kind of a crazy Irish wolf grin.
They stand up and gather their skirts and fans and, like, shuffle inside.
That's how you handle them, Thorfinn. Just give them a little bit of a grin, and they run off with their petticoats and in a twist.
But,
sorry.
You're a family man, right?
Oi. Well, of course, I've been married for 5 years now.
5 years. That's a long time.
Well, you know, there's no use in waiting when you know when you've got the right lad.
Is she...
Besides, if I didn't, her dad would have killed me.
What did you do?
Well, back where I'm from, when you want a wife, and you meet a girl, and you have some special feelings for her, what you do is you sneak into their dad's house late at night, and you spirit her away to come live with you and be your wife, you know?
Sounds awfully, and he kind of stutters, romantic.
You've never met a more romantic people than the Irish. We love a good song, we love a good drink, we love a good fuck. But we always go back to our wives.
You remind me of my own people.
We also enjoy
the songs. We enjoy the pillaging, we enjoy the ease of things in life.
We've got a couple of you Norsemen come along the islands every once in a while. They come out of the sea.
They come on, they drink, they break a few things, and they leave, you know? It's the way of things. We do the same thing to the British.
I know one like the man of the angels. They worship this weird god of compassion. I cannot fathom. And he's even big in the Scandinavian countries now. People have forgotten the old ways.
Oh, well, that's some weird Eastern religion I don't cotton with, my people. They come around sometimes, you know. We give them a smile, play along, and then as soon as they leave, we just go back to whatever you were doing with. That's the best way to handle this here, Eastern gold that they come around, this Jesus Christ.
Pardon me, lads. I don't mean to intrude.
There's like this short little dude in like a black suit, a purple shirt, and like a white collar. He's got a bunch of rings on, and he's walking with like a fancy cane, and he's got a big gold crucifix around his neck and like a white hat.
I don't mean to pry or interrupt your conversation, boys, but did I hear the two of you saying that you've not yet accepted the Lord Jesus Christ into your life?
Well, I don't know.
I find that hard to believe, especially for you, sir. And he looks at you, Donnie. You look like a good old Catholic boy.
Well, you know, I was dragged down to a big old building when I was a wee lad, and they dunked my head in some water, and they said, well, there you go, you're good now. Go on, son, your sins are forgiven. So, that's good enough for them, that's good enough for me, then,
Oh, my dear boy, are you saying you haven't had any proper Christian education since your baptism? Mercy me. Here, you two boys need these. He reaches into his coat. And he pulls out two small glass bottles filled with like an amber-colored liquid with corks stopping them and like little flyers adhered to like the front of them with the Westboro Baptist Church on the front.
Reverend, okay, Fred Phelps.
You boys enjoy those now. Remember, God is a given and forgiven God. No matter what you've done through his salvation, you can be brought together again with the holy fold to live eternally blissful in heaven. Amen, amen, I say to you. Pardon me now, Miss Scarlet. And he starts walking over towards the saloon whorehouse. I believe it is time for your noontime lessons. Shall we adjourn? And they head inside the saloon.
And
holding this bottle, like you each have a little bottle.
Thorfinn pockets the bottle and kind of lowers his voice and goes down to McCormick. He kind of whispers, let's not talk until we come to the sheriff's office now, shall we? I can't stand this. And he snuffs.
Boy, let's get out of here. This town is weird. I don't cotton with these folks. They're all Englishmen. Gets me dander up. Don't know how my kinfolk stand it. And I head off to the... And I head off. Like, kind of shoving whatever in my, like, little rabbit skin bag. Like, this bottle. Actually, I sniff it first.
It smells strongly of whiskey.
Alright. Like, shove it in there, and I'll head back. I'll head off to the church.
Actually, not knowing what to make of it. Urge too.
Perception primal urge.
Eric, you as well.
Perception, primal urge?
Yes, please.
Difficulty 6?
Yep.
Lots of successes.
Alright. Eric, you think it smells, like, delicious. It smells like the best whiskey you've ever smelled. And, Chris, you pick up a slight... It's almost imperceptible, but with your plenty of successes, you pick up a slight hint of worm taint in this liquor.
All right, I take it, and I look at Thorfinn and I go, "Hey, don't drink that. It smells off."
Why?
Oh, it's been tainted with the worm. I don't know. This man. We got to report this back to the Sept as soon as we get back. That we smelled worm. This man's passing out worm taint in the town. In these bottles.
And as he kind of hears McCormick say this, he kind of flutters up with rage as the worm is one of the greatest enemies of everyone.
Alright, so roll a frenzy thing.
I'm gonna die.
Wait, don't play fringing in the middle of town.
It's what should I roll with?
Roll your rage, and the difficulty is your willpower.
How did we do with calm hearts on this?
It's at a higher difficulty. So I think it's +2 difficulty. It might be +1.
Cool.
Hold on, let me look it up.
I think it says like +2 dice or whatever, but
fuck it. Alright, if it's +2 dice, then hold on. I found it. Hold on. Raise the difficulty on all your frenzy rolls by 2. Alright, okay. So what's your willpower +2?
I think that's a 6.
Alright, so roll rage. You roll your rage at difficulty 6. You want to fail.
Yeah, I get 3 successes. No, 4, actually. Like, because 10 is double.
I don't think you get a specialty in it, but...
Yeah, no, you don't. It's 3, but yeah, you fucking frenzy.
And 4?
Yeah, you frenzy.
Cool. So, yeah, what...
So you are filled with, like, the fucking righteous rage of Gaia. It just bubbles up from your very, like, stomach, black, bileless anger up, like, into your brain, and you fucking... Everything goes red, basically, and this dude is passing out worm taint to innocent people and just gave it to 2 guru and then went off to fuck whores in the whorehouse. Like, who is this guy? And you want him dead and you want all the worm taint cleansed from this town now. So what do you do?
Fuck. Whoever kind of stops, drops the vial and just turns around and goes for the saloon and for this man.
Right, I can probably tell that he, like, started to, like, fucking, like, go off on it.
Yeah. He just, like, drops his bottle, smashes in the dusty street, and he's like, "Worm taint!" and goes off towards the fucking saloon.
Shit, I'm gonna try to stare him down so he doesn't... Like, so he doesn't, like, fucking, like, start to, like, frenzy in the middle of fucking town and break fucking delirium.
He already frenzied. Oh, does he? Do you instantly shift to Krenos when you frenzy?
No.
I don't think so either.
No, but what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try to, like, grab him and steer him down so he doesn't, like, run off and start killing things in the middle, in front of everybody.
Alright, go ahead and try to grapple him.
Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to, like, grab him and try to be like, "Oi, we'll meet him later. We'll get him when he comes out. We'll jump him in the alley or something."
You're vaguely aware of your buddy trying to stop you. Want him out of your way so you can kill more things.
I'm
very angry that he's trying to stop you.
I'll spend a willpower, I guess. So yes, calm myself down.
All right, roll another rage roll.
I think he botched. So
you fucking, you need to go Krenos right now and kill the town.
Oh man, can you spend a willpower to like negate that?
Nope, he botched.
He
botched trying to snap out of rage.
What do you roll to
snap out of rage?
I don't know. I don't know.
Like, whatever it was, though, like regardless of what he was supposed to be rolling, like no matter what, like you still botched.
Yay. The player can spend a willpower point immediately to halt the frenzy. It says.
So. Okay, you can halt it for like a second, so fine. Chris, go ahead and roll your stare down or whatever, but I don't know, man. I think that you like trying to calm yourself down, botching would make you frenzy harder.
So what is that charisma freaking...
I think it's a gift, and I think it's rank 2, and I think it's a Philodox gift.
Well, can't you just like try to like do not necessarily the stare down gift, but just like try to get him to like fucking turn over or whatever.
I mean, if he wasn't frenzying, then probably.
Describe geographically like the area around them, right?
Dead center of town. They're right in front of the saloon. There's like the blacksmith place, the livery store.
I'm gonna grab him and try to just fucking drag him into the thing before he fucking
push him into a building. Yeah.
No.
I'm just gonna grab him and pull him into the alley.
All right. So make a strength brawl or whatever versus his strength brawl.
If you spend a willpower point, can he be willingly going there? Because he has like a turn to himself, right?
Yeah, fine. So you get one turn. Whatever, you can willingly get pulled into the alleyway, I suppose. But then you gotta roll something to snap out, and I'm pretty sure it's rage. And you botched that roll, and a botch is the worst possible thing that can happen. And the worst possible thing that could happen at that point is you freaking out, going into like worm thrall.
The book says normally that you can spend a will to halt your frenzy. So on a botch, why don't we say that? Instead of spending a will and being able to halt your frenzy, you can spend a will to direct your frenzy, but you can't stop it.
Okay, that sounds good to me. So you don't have to kill Chris right now, but you need to go kill that man immediately.
Like, I'm just... Oh, whatever. You know, you're the fucking GM, but I kind of find it bullshit, but whatever. So, yeah, guess I need to go and kill this guy.
Okay,
hold on, Eric.
You can spend the willpower to halt your frenzy, not to completely stop it forever. Like, you get a turn to try to compose yourself. You made the roll, and you botched on it. So I don't see what's bullshit. Like, I don't understand.
Well, first of all, I can't go into Fall of the Worm. So, I just find it bullshit. No, I cannot. I need 6 successes.
If you can
I don't find...
Alright, so I'm letting you not kill Chris, right? You're still... This isn't like Vampire where it's like, oh, my beast, I'm so pissed, I'll just spend a willpower. It's like, I am the fucking avatar of rage. Like, this dude is passing out worm tanks.
I'm saying that just because I did one botch... And, you know, there's no rules for
Dude, everybody goes, it's just one botch. Oh, it's just one botch. That's what everybody says. You don't want to botch. It's bad. Especially when
no one does vampire rules.
All right, you're frenzying.
Yeah, whatever.
All right.
So I'm going to go and kill this guy.
All right.
No, I just pull him in there. I pull him into the alley so he doesn't, like, freak out in the middle of goddamn town square right. in the middle of the day.
Since he's halted frenzy, like, can't he, like, spend, like, a gnosis and just, like, step sideways and frenzy in the Umbra?
Rules.
Oh, no.
I'm not saying that. I'm just trying to get him out of, like, the fucking town so, like, we don't have, like, a fucking... Oh my god!
Alright, well, so for six seconds, you start to compose yourself. He pulls you into the alleyway. Now you're frenzying.
Can I try to talk him down at all? Is there anything, or do you need to be like a shoulder the guy or some shit for that?
If this was the normal failure, you could try all these things, stepping into the Umbra and all kinds of shit, but you botched.
Okay, so does you have to ride it out till the frenzy ends, or is it like a turn by turn?
Till the stimulus of his frenzy is destroyed, or he is like completely away from it, I suppose. So if Chris were to overpower him and drag him away, but you would be fighting as hard as you could, yeah.
Actually, wouldn't this be the opposite? Because successes actually mean that you frenzy on a rage roll.
Yeah.
So lack of successes would mean like he's denied his rage for a certain amount of time or
but
something.
Not on a botch. Because a botch is supposed to be whatever the worst thing that could happen is. And that's
I feel like the worst thing that could happen was like until like a moon phase change, he just doesn't have access to rage because he didn't get successes towards a rage, he got a botch. So it should go the opposite direction.
I think that would be fucking him over worse. I think I'm just gonna have him frenzy.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
And, we did rage rolls weird as well. It's going to be at the moon. Fuck it. You know, yeah, do whatever because I'm going to go into frenzy. So whatever.
Oh, okay. I just want to know, out of character, what moon phase are we in right now? Just so
I know. It's about to be the full moon tonight.
Okay.
That's why the lady was saying that she would give you a full moon special, half price on butt sex.
Okay.
Yeah, that dude just entered the saloon that you guys fucked up in a gunfight yesterday. So what are you doing?
Well, you know, it's said us already. Yes, I'm going to kill this guy. I don't have control over my own character right now.
So. Well, you do. You have to role play out being in frenzy.
Well, I can go in there and try to kill him.
You are in absolute Viking mode. And this guy is the enemy.
Fuck him up, bro. Yeah.
As is anything that gets in your way. Short of Chris.
So basically, this guy. So Donnie is in the way. I'm just going to try to push Donnie out of the way. And I guess that's a strength plus whatever roll.
Strength brawl if you're trying to like throw him out of your way.
I would push him out with my hand. Right, it's not so the hand right now.
Roll a dex brawl then.
That's four successes.
Alright, so roll strength. And add three. Chris, you can try to dodge if you'd like.
Alright, I guess I will then.
Four successes.
Alright.
What do you get? Three successes.
Okay. You got four successes before. Oh, you got three?
I haven't rolled yet.
Oh, okay.
But I got one, two, three successes.
Alright, never mind. He hits you really hard out of the way, kind of like bats you out of the way with his arm and take four bashing. You can soak it, obviously.
Oh, I wasn't trying to hit him. I was just going to try to like push him.
You're in a frenzy.
I don't do any.
Okay.
You know what? Fuck this guy. I'm gonna basically just try to have to fucking, goddamn. Not a whole lot I can do here. That's why I fucking hate everyone plays an Orun.
This is the drawback to being the strongest, most rage-filled member of Gaia's Rage. Sometimes you fucking freak out when it's real inconvenient.
Fuck this guy. I'm gonna use a gift on him to try to fucking power him down so I can do shit. This like isn't necessarily an attack. I just smell really bad, so it fucking like negates all your shit. What's your stamina?
That's a 4.
Of course it is.
First physical man.
No, it's like everyone wants to make like these stupid fucking combat monkeys, and then make one, you just end up being fucked.
You don't get to outfight Aruns.
I mean, Aruns are an auspice.
See, what the fuck is the... I gotta look this
fucking up. I found it. Spend a point of rage and roll stamina primal urge difficulty of stamina of target stamina +5. For every success roll, the target loses one die from all actions for the next turn. Okay. If 5 successes are rolled, he's incapacitated. He basically starts puking because it smells so bad.
Oh, God.
So you need 5 9s or better.
Alright, well, I'm gonna spend a willpower point on this.
Right.
So that way it'll at least get one.
Nice.
So, not really.
Well, it's not a boss, right?
Yeah, you got 2 successes, so you're at -2 for your next action, Eric.
Cool.
Well, long as I keep it up.
Yeah. Well, no. From all actions for the next turn.
Okay. And then I'm going to try to, while he's doing that... does that take a whole action to activate the gift or not?
No, like half. You can still move or whatever, but you can't attack again.
I was thinking about just going into fucking Glabro.
You can do that.
Okay, I'll do that then. Because I'm going to spin the rage and I'm just going to have to beat this guy down.
Alright. Eric, you have moved this smelly man from barring your path. You can enter the saloon now. You're fucking heated.
So, yeah. I'm doing that. And as he enters, he kind of goes, "Where is the priest?"
Everyone's like, "Oh my god! What the fuck?" Because, like, your rage is fucking... pouring out of your pores. You look like a fucking... You look like a dude on PCP. You're like, "Where's the fucking priest?"
Okay, come inside. He just pushed back me into the fucking thing.
Yeah.
So there's... Does it happen before I get to shift or not? Because if he already pushed me and entered the thing before I shift, then I won't shift.
Yeah,
because
he did it before you even used your city-smelling thing.
Okay. Then forget it, then. I'm just going to, like, make myself scarce.
Okay.
And, maybe I'll have to break this guy out of jail.
Alright, the bartender draws a shotgun, Eric, and he points it at you and says, yeah, you gotta get out of here, mister. This is a bad idea on his part.
Right. So I'm just gonna I'm gonna activate Visitor Fenris and just... Say to everyone to get the fuck out of of the bar.
Okay.
Because I'm fucking pissed. Well, this was fun playing this character. And I fucking botch. So I look up like a puppy or something.
So you're like, "Everybody get out of here! I'm gonna tear that priest apart, and the dude fucking shoots at you.
From what I can look up, it looks like if you botch a rage roll, you actually enter Fox Frenzy and just run away like a little bitch.
Yep.
Alright, well, the thing is, though, I don't know what the roll is to come out of rage, and since he was using that roll, like, regardless of what he was rolling, he was using the roll to come out of frenzy and botched.
That's cool. That's cool. I was just telling you what I found.
Alright, so next, time, if you're making a rage roll for something and you botch, you will go into Fox Frenzy. However, I'm liking that if you are trying to come out of rage and you botch, you rage harder. Because that makes sense to me.
Okay, sounds good.
Right on. Alright, so you botched your visage of Fenris. Yeah, whatever. So the dude just shoots at you with his shotgun. Needs two successes. So. Boom! Roll to soak 3 points of damage as you get peppered with a buckshot from one of the barrels of the shotgun.
I take one.
Okay. You take lethal, yeah. You take 1 point of lethal. This dude just shot you. He is obviously of the worm.
So, yeah. I guess I go Krinos, or whatever.
Alright.
Nice.
Yeah. So, you want to spend the rage, or...
Yeah, I'm going to pop a rage and go Krinos.
Alright. Boom. Krinos, he goes into delirium. I gotta roll for delirium or something to see what happens, right? Delirium chart.
Unless, like, they have, like, more of the four, isn't it?
Hold on. Creatures affected by delirium. Oh, it goes on their, it goes by their willpower. Okay.
I think it's like if people have like 8 in willpower or something like that. I don't know.
I found a chart right here. I think this looks good. 1 is catatonic fear, 2 is panic, 3 is disbelief, 4 is berserk, 5 is terror, which is what he's got. Whatever. So he goes into terror. He sees you get blasted by buckshot, and then just immediately turn into a huge werewolf, and he goes, "Oh shit!" and ducks behind the bar. You hear like a slam of a trapdoor and a lock. You notice, actually, roll a perception alertness.
Shit. Yeah, give me a minute. Shit! I'm fucking around. Not having the right window open. Here we go. I get 2 successes.
Okay. You notice that priest guy looking wide-eyed at you from the top of the stairs.
Right. So I'm just gonna run at him. Yeah, like, up the stairs. Or maybe I can't do that because I'm fucking tall as shit. I'm just gonna jump up.
Alright. As you jump up, he goes into catatonic fear and just kind of like lays on the ground and starts, he's like, "Oh, help me, Jesus!" and falls to the floor. So you leap to the top of these stairs, unless you want to roll for it. You can roll to see if you like, fall down.
Yeah,
I'll just let you leap.
So... Can I make the assumption that I can take him to the moot, or should I just kill him right here and now?
You need to murder this worm-tainted piece of shit and get rid of all the rest of his bottles he's got on him. Yeah. Alright, so if you'd like to, go ahead and describe what you do to this guy, and if you don't want to, I will do it.
Like, okay, so he begins to, like, just claw out up, like, the entire body of this guy. Biting into him, ripping shredding with his claws, taking limb and limb. Like, you know, taking each limb and just shredding it, holding him up for everyone to see. And then he pops the head off and just throws it down into the saloon floor.
All right. And Chris, as you're leaving the area, the horrified, like, open mouth face and head of the priest comes rolling out of the saloon door, leaving like a thick, dark red trail behind it.
I like face palm a little bit.
All right, Eric, after this dude is completely pulped. Oh, sorry, go ahead, Chris.
Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to like basically kick the thing back in the deal before anyone else leaves. And I'm going to walk in there, like, just kind of pissed, and I'm going to see who the fuck is in there.
Okay, the bartender's nowhere to be seen. All the whores have seemingly run in terror and locked themselves into their rooms. There's one dude who is, he's, like, staring at Eric at the top of the stairs. He's like, oh my god, please! Please, anything you want, don't hurt me. I'll go to the register. I'll get the money for you. And he goes to the register and starts, like, punching register buttons, trying to get money out. And, like, he's like, I can't get the register open. Here, have some bottles of liquor. And he starts putting liquor into a fucking blanket and wrapping it up and trying to, like, hold it up to Eric. And Eric, as you finish, like, mulching this guy and you throw his head out the door, it gets kicked back inside and you snap to your senses. You're in Krenos. You're caked in blood. You got bits of pieces of, like, disgusting-tasting human flesh in your mouth and all over your hands. And it's reminding you of a certain incident back in good old Sweden.
So he looks down to Donnie and kind of gets the face off, oh shit, I fucked up, didn't I?
Is there like a back way out of here?
Yeah, there's one back door behind the bar.
Alright, so I look at everybody, they're freaking out. The only thing I can hope is that,
well, basically there's nobody anymore in this main room. All the whores locked themselves in the rooms, and this one guy is like feverishly trying to please Eric by giving him liquor and money.
I pull out my gun and I shoot him in the face, trying to cover up in case the guy like might break the veil that way.
Go ahead and roll it.
If the guy gets shot,
it's going to be like difficulty 3.
All right, so that's 2 successes.
Alright, you shoot him in the head and he dies.
Alright. And, then I grab, is Thorfinn still in Krenos?
Yep. Unless you want to shift back down, you can totally do that now.
Yeah, I'm going back to Quamid.
Okay.
Well, as he's like, shrinking, I, like, grab him by, like, the scruff of his neck or something.
Mm-hmm.
And start dragging him out. I walk in. I just shoot the guy square in the face. I look at Thorfinn, like, scowling. And I grab him by the scruff of his neck and just try to drag him out. And if he resists, he'll probably, like, own me, but whatever.
He won't resist.
All right, so when you shifted back, all your clothes that were bound to you, like, come back. But since you weren't wearing them in Krenos, your like actual naked body is what's covered in blood. So all this blood starts to like seep through your clothes from the inside.
Right.
You still have like bits of dude under your fingernails. Your mouth is still full of blood and pieces of people, and like actually, there's like a big chunk of scalp and hair hanging out.
How far away is it? Okay, is there a way to get out of town through the alleys?
There's not really many alleys. It's like spaced out.
Is the town? Well, I know that like there's like a main street where all the buildings are facing it, but right. How like on the side streets are they very fucking? They're usually not very populous.
There are not really any side streets. It's just like there's the main stretch of town.
So it's a movie western town.
Exactly. It's fucking.
Okay, like, I'm gonna drag the dude off into like the fucking scrub, all bloody and shit.
Okay, so you gotta take him out the back door.
Yeah, which is if like the main door is facing the street, then that's like just dragging him out of town.
Yeah, the back.
I'm gonna try to like hide him behind a bush or in a gully or something and get him cleaned
up. Let's not get ahead of ourselves now. Bushes and gullies. You haven't even left the bar yet.
I'm gonna look out the door then.
All right, so you open the door.
See if there's anybody there.
You open the door behind the bar, and it leads into another room, where the sheriff and several of his friends have flipped a card table and have guns behind it, and they're like, "What the fuck's going on out there?"
And be like, "Oh my god!" I'm gonna look at them. And be like, oh my god, somebody fucking ran in here. It was a wild animal.
Wild animal, did you get it? Heard gunshots.
I don't know. Somebody firing and I think he like get a wild shot and got the freaking bartender.
Alright, roll a manipulation subterfuge.
Alright. What's my subterfuge? I'm going to spend a willpower on this, too.
Yo, how many willpower do you have? Because you spent three last
time. Well, it's been like a day, so I get one back every night.
Right. So
I've got seven, so.
All right. Just keep track of them.
All right, so, I think I only spit the one like to freaking try to brawl the guy, which didn't work.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see here.
So you got four left.
It was subterfuge. It's four dice. Not great. Three successes, maybe four, with the willpower.
Okay, it's diff six, so yeah.
It tore this poor preacher man apart.
All right,
poor preacher man apart.
You got one success. Oh my god, it must be those fucking Injuns and their wolves.
I don't know. I don't think it might have been a. It might have been a dog or like a puma or something.
All right, they all like they get up. The sheriff grabs his rifle. The rest of them have just like pistols and stuff. There's like five dudes all together. And they get up and they start walking out the door that you're standing in front of. And then they catch sight of Eric, who's covered in blood and has pieces of men hanging out of his mouth. And they're like, what in
the hell? He was right next to the guy who got savaged by the wild beast. He saw it all.
Roll me another subterfuge. You can both do one if you want.
Mine sucks. Big time. So Torfin's just gonna look kind of cut-taconic and just look down at the floor.
Okay.
Which he probably more or less is. Alright.
Hold on. Tarnation, you're a liar! That boy's a cannibal! We're taking him in! And they all point their guns at Thorfinn. He's got bits of man hanging out of his teeth. Wait, you know what? I don't know if he's a cannibal, but like we're not letting either one of you go. Like, why don't you boys take a seat, have a drink, and wait for the Union Army boys to show up and sort this out. This is way beyond what I'm trained to deal with. I'm a goddamn lawman. I'm not a monster hunter, cannibal catching, coon wrangling. Fuck. He just like gets a bottle of whiskey and takes a slug, but they're all these five dudes are pointing their guns at you two. Take a seat now.
Yeah.
All right, Larry, I want you to run down to Fort Carson. I want you to get the lieutenant and tell him we need a regiment to come and watch this town. Because this is 2 days in a row that wild gunfights have happened at this fucking saloon and people are dead and this guy's got pieces of scalp hanging out of his mouth covered in blood. This guy's telling me that they are some kind of wild animal. Where the hell's the bartender?
Well, ask the horse. Like, he got shot. Someone just shot him.
You hear, like, coming from beneath your feet.
All right, so what?
Get out of here! Get off the trap door, Codflapper! Flapper.
That sounds like Mickey the bartender. Move your feet there, Irish man.
All right, so I'm gonna basically like back up to the end of the fucking thing. I ain't done nothing, officer. Why am I being detained against my will? So, of course, miscarriage of justice.
You show up in town and there's two gunfights in the same place in 2 days. You tell me why you're being detained. Ain't nobody else around.
It's not my fault. You're
the only one who got to see what's going on. You ain't leaving until I get a statement.
You got my statement already?
You ain't leaving until Lieutenant Williams from the goddamn Fort Carson getting your army statement!
It's you detained me against my will. I've not done nothing wrong, officer.
I've got damn law around here. I'll detain you whenever I want for whatever reason until the jury comes to circuit.
So all the deputies are all these new deputies? I look at Thorfinn and I go, see what happens when you fucking can't control yourself? And I look, is this got, like, what kind of doors are on? How many people are in this place?
It's the five lawmen, and it's just, like, the swinging door on the front, and, like, you can see through the room that they were all in, there's, like, a back door that leads onto, like, a porch.
I, like, look at the guy and I go, well, it looks like we can't be going back into town then. And I just, like, grab the dude. And I, like, just bolt out the back.
Alright.
There's no way I'm gonna fucking let the goddamn army.
Do a dex athletics to juke these drunk lawmen out.
Two successes. Right, they're gonna beat me because they apparently have like huge.
All right. No, they don't. So stop whining, because that was I don't know, some wits and something else. But anyway, you're able to like this dude, since it's the Wild West. And there's no such thing as high blood pressure medication. This dude made himself, like, lightheaded. And you're able to, like, juke out the sheriff. He spins in a circle, all of his drunken lawmen fumbling about as, like, Mickey the bartender comes out of the basement, like, what's going on? Is it gone? There's a goddamn bear! And, you know, you grab Thorfinn and make it out to the back porch. And you hear the sheriff's men going, cat! Damn it! Go get him!
Alright.
So, the two of you make Dex Athletics. If you're just, like, running away. Unless you're doing something else.
We're running.
It depends. What's the area like?
Basically, it's a straight shot of wide open, like, dusty ground up until the Fianna Bar, and then the woods.
I'm just going to make a bolt for the woods.
All right. Thorfinn, you got four successes right on.
Yeah. Of course, I got a fucking roll, which means I got one success.
All right. So Thorfinn, you fucking bolt. Super, super fast, and you get about halfway to the Fianna Bar,
in one round. And you look back over your shoulder, like, momentarily, and there's Donnie, all out of shape from drinking and eating bacon with his wife, huffing and puffing with, like, his shoes that are too small, running after you. And all two of the sheriff's men make it to the back door. And one of them's like, "There you go, sheriff. They're heading for the Mick bar."
And I'm just bolting for the straight for the woods.
Yeah, woods.
Okay.
Ooh. I'm not trying to all go right into any building.
So check it out. This dude just botched. He tries to take a shot at Donnie with his big like pistol. He's like, "I got you now, you motherfucker!" And he pulls the trigger, and it fucking is an inferior quality gun. And it backfires, blows his hand off his body, like a bloody stump. And some little weird dude in town notices that and is like, "Huh." And then the sheriff is like, "God fucking damn it, not again!" And this dude falls to the floor screaming with blood issuing from his fucking hand wound. And you two can make your fair escape into the woods, where Atchajack has fucked off into.
Oh, I'm just gonna drag this guy back and like fucking have his goddamn like pack alpha like kick the crap out of him for fringing in the middle of town.
All right, back at the Sept, Atchajack and pins the hair and fucking chases the storm, have made it back to the Moot Rock, pins the hair and chases the storm, have brought back two mostly intact carcasses of deer when an unfamiliar howl to everybody but pins the hair, comes from the woods. And Rob, if you would like to give your howl of introduction, now would be the good time.
All right.
You missed some shit, boy.
I saw some shit, though.
That whatever. Was a good... Like, people don't frenzy just because you say, "Oh, this is like this guy's handing out worm tainted stuff," or whatever.
Mm. Eric suggested it, and I like to go with what the players say, unless they're trying to help themselves out, in which case I like to go against what they say.
Womp womp. Anyway, from the outskirts of the Bond, I would guess.
Yep.
You guys hear a howl that sounds sort of like wind mixing with a wolf howl. And in Mother's tongue it says, "I am Frozen Pelt, friend of bears. Wendigo Arun Clyeth. I seek entrance into this cairn."
Pins the hair's ears will prick up, and he'll look over to Craxley Canyon, who's sitting by the fire, and like a low droning howl, obviously coming from Ahamid, in Mother's tongue or whatever, says, whatever, cracks the canyon, Croatan Elder, Alpha of the Sept, like, grants you entry, little nigga. Come inside and meet us at the Moot Rock at the foot of the canyon.
My character comes through.
Okay. It's not hard to find. It's a huge canyon, and at the south end of it, there's a big rock with, like, a totem pole on it.
Yeah, it's pretty obvious.
Yes.
Even to, you know.
So sitting around the totem pole is Pins the Hair in Hamid form, who's trying to properly prepare a deer carcass so that Atchajack can eat it. Atchajack. And a wolf named Chases the Storm. And also the Alpha of the Sept, who is this really old-looking, like, Cree lady. She's got skin the color and texture of like a dried out riverbed, all cracked and aged. She's wearing like buffalo and deer skin blankets all wrapped around her. Some of them are painted, some of them aren't. And she's got like a headdress, because that's what Injuns look like.
Cool.
She's got like a fire going, and they're all just sitting around. Pins the Hair waves at you.
Gonna pat over to Pins the Hair and sit down and basically look at you, look at the carcasses and the deer, and sort of tilt my head as in a, what are you doing?
Point over at Atchachak, Hamid, and points at the Alpha. Alpha, like meat tasted by fire, cleaning it so they can eat it properly. That one, he points at the one that chases the storm, is like whatever he's doing, eating or banging or something, will not be cooked. Atchachak chases storm. This is brother.
Hello, brother. And welcome.
Chases the storm just says, brother.
My character nods. Looks over at, who's the alpha again? I'm sorry.
Her name is Cracks the Canyon.
Oh, and that's the woman that's tending the fire, yeah?
Mm-hmm. She says, welcome, grandson. Pins the Hair was very worried that you had lost your way. Hopefully your timely arrival has put his mind at rest. Tell us, where are you coming from?
North.
I see. You have not been to the human village with the iron snake? And she points to the southwest.
I try to stay away from humans.
Very good. We are expecting friends. Come, sit by the fire. I'm sorry, grandchild. Did you say something? These ears are not what they used to be.
What kind of friends?
There is guru friends, white men.
His hackle is a little bit, not sort of like a sneer almost.
You will, I take it, take some adjusting before you are ready to accept the European guru as your brothers. This is understandable. And then Pins the Hair kind of chimes in. White men, save cub. Take honorable injuries, saving cub. Our friends.
He lies down.
And I'll just go back to cutting up this carcass. All right. So basically, at this point, Donnie and Thorfinn, if you want, can come staggering to the moot rock.
Well, I will sit there, like, just, like, royally pissed at carrying this fucking, like, basically just dragging this dude to the rock. I don't know if he's, like, resisting me or not by now.
All right, so just as Pins the Hair and Cracks the Canyon are like, oh, yeah, these are great. These white men, they're great. They're our friends. They're so good at their job. They rescue cubs like it's nothing. Here comes this pissed-off-looking Irish guy who looks like he's been running, like, through the woods for a long stretch of time because he fucking has. And this other white guy, huge, blonde-haired, blue-eyed dude, covered in blood, caked in blood. He reeks of, like, dead human offal. He's got, like, shit and blood all under his fingernails and in his mouth and in his teeth. Caked, just covered in blood all over the place. And Pins the Hair will kind of, like, take a couple steps back and shift into Lupus and start growling at the two of them.
I mean, I probably would have stopped. And, I don't know, you don't have to howl every time you enter, do you?
You're sort of supposed to.
Yeah, well, I probably would have stopped at the barn and, said that I was coming.
Oh, yeah, well, that's fine. So you totally could have announced yourselves, but he's still, like, freaked out and just, like,
Okay. I don't know who's freaking out, which one.
There. Right. Not freaking out. He's just growling at you a little bit, like, what the fuck?
I will like, sit there, and I will, like, kind of, like, once we get into there to the moot rock, like, let him go and be like...
Eric, like, roll a perception of this.
Like, not really, like, knowing what to do, because I'm still a Kleath and kind of young. Just kind of, like, throw, like, in frustration... And be like,
Grr. Yeah.
Okay, so with those three successes, you hear off towards the tree line that same laughter from before.
And he looks at him, get up and walk over to Pins the Hair. Smell of man taint.
Smell of awful.
Thorfinn looks into the bushes and mutters, "Something is watching us. Something does this to me. This is not my doing. I would never do this."
And Cracks the Canyon kind of, like, steps forward with, like, wide eyes and everything, and she's got her hands on her staff. She uses it to, like, walk over to you. She gets really close to your face, and she looks really, really pissed at you. And then she pulls a piece of her blanket, spits in it, and starts wiping the blood off your face.
You got grandma ragged.
Yeah, you did. What happened?
The Fenris took control of me. I lost my sane senses. We were given these vials of human-made whiskey, and it was tainted by the worm.
It's only had a wee bit of the taint. This guy's going to frenzy every time he encounters the taint. What good is he?
Worm-tainted whiskey, you say?
I take the bottle that I, like, still have, like, in my pouch, and be like, this needs a right to cleansing on it?
She, like, takes the bottle from you, gently uncorks it with her fingers, gives it, like, just the slightest ever sniff, makes, like, a disgusted face, recorks it, puts it down on the floor, and she fucking whacks you on top of the head with her staff. She's like, you might have cleansing these things before you bring them onto the bond. Your lucky ultimatum wasn't here. That is all right. But
Chases the storm, issues a low growl whenever she says ultimatum's name.
She just doesn't pay any mind to it, but she gives you maybe like a little sideways glance, like, calm down there, Sparky. Were you seen? Did he pierce the veil?
No. Well, delirium or the forgetfulness set in.
Tried to cover it up as well as I could, but...
What the fuck? But you are no Ragabash. She starts rubbing her temples. Even if they do not remember Thorfinn, it is still lifting the veil to needlessly adopt the war form. I understand that you are in a rune. I understand that the rage is strong within you. However, what McCormick says does ring true. If you are going to be unable to control your anger at the slightest provocation, she picks up the bottle, uncorks it, sniffs it again, and waves it in front of you, then you are not prepared to be sent out into the world on business for Gaia. For the time being, I'm going to put you under the tutelage of Ultimatum. Perhaps he will be able to assist you in tempering your rage. Gaia knows he has much of it.
I will break in. I would like to teach brother. I would really? Teach brother. Yes. Make stronger bond between pure ones and your and white man.
I had not thought of it this way. She bends down and she just kind of like pets your chest area a couple of times. Like really old shaky grandma hand, like a little pat. This shows wisdom beyond your age. Chases the storm.
Who else is in this room?
Everybody.
Okay, so I'll kind of say a little loud so everyone can hear. Will Ultimatum not be upset once this news hits his ears that instead of he, this tutelage was given to one of such low rank?
Ultimatum is the warden of the Sept and has many responsibilities. And while I am certain that he would like nothing better than to personally see to it that you never make this mistake again, I will talk with him, and I am the Alpha. I think that what Chases the Storm says would be the wisest course of action. It will, at least in this one case, bridge the gap between not only the European Guru and the Pure Ones, but also between the Hamids and the Lupus. Shit. She breaks like something. Thorfinn, you should cleanse yourself and your belongings at the mouth of the stream. She points to, like, way up to the other side of the canyon where the mouth of the stream has, like, a little waterfall. And as for this, she takes the bottle and hands it over to Pins the Hair. I believe you can take care of this, Pins. And he, like, wolf nods or whatever, takes the bottle in his mouth gingerly and starts trotting up towards the mouth of the stream after Thorfinn. The rest of you guys can feel free to converse with her. And I'll get to Thorfinn and Pins in just a minute.
I'll lean over towards Thorfinn and whisper. Actually, not whisper. I'll speak like loudly so everyone can hear. You say you heard sounds outside.
As he makes himself ready to leave, he nods, yes, laughing.
First time?
Yes.
I'll step outside and have a look around.
Alright.
Here we go.
I intend to be trotting behind Pins the Hare and Thorfinn.
Okay, that's fine.
Who's going with Pins of the Hare?
Chases the Storm.
And Thorfinn. And anyone else who would like, or anyone who would like to follow Ziggy can do the same, or if anyone wants to do anything else, that was the time.
I'm just going to head off and go off in the woods and like claw up like a tree and break a rock or something.
All right.
As you're leaving, I'll glance over to you and I'll say, McCormack, deed, land.
Yeah, I take it and I go, yeah, well, I like sit there and like kind of like take it out, unfold it, and like just kind of like put my hand on it, like not threateningly, but like just like with it on my hand, put it on his chest, like saying like I'm done with this shit.
It's fucking stupid, dude.
I nod and
I sit there and I look at it and I go like, and I don't even say anything, but my body language universally between Hamids would be known. It's like, no.
All right, I'll grab the deed and give you a friendly nod of thanks.
And I'm probably going to like go off in the woods, like switch to Krynos and like outside of the cairn, just rip something to fucking shreds because I'm pissed.
All right, right on. You find, like, oh, actually, I'll get to you in a second, but, Rob, are you coming with us, or going with Ziggy, or doing something else?
I'm gonna make sure you don't get in any trouble touching, worm-taining things brought to you by Paleface.
Very good. Alright, so let's go over there. We'll go to the mouth of the stream. Get to the mouth of the stream, Pins the Hare, shifts back into Hamid form, breaks a little branch off of that's growing out of the side of the canyon, and he'll light it on something. I forgot that I probably should have done this by the fire, but whatever. He goes off to the fire and lights the fucking thing, and then comes back. And starts doing his weird little theurge dance around this bottle of liquor to cleanse it. You and Chases the Storm and Thorfinn are there. Thorfinn, there's like ice cold waterfall water running down from this thing into the stream.
Reminds him of home. he cleanses himself work.
Alright. So yeah, Thorfinn starts scrubbing himself. I'll dance around him once he's naked.
Can Wendigo glance into the Umbra without going through?
Yeah, whatever.
I'm going to watch them in the Umbra and watch the surrounding area.
Okay. There's,
Like?
Huh?
Just, keep in mind danger sense.
Okay. You don't sense any danger right here except for, like, across the canyon where there's a fuck ton of red talons. But even that doesn't come up too hard because they are your brothers.
Yeah, the red town.
They're still dangerous, though. That's all I'm saying. Yeah, no, there's no immediate threats around here. And in the Umbra, there seems to be, like, a lot of raccoon spirits around lately.
Hmm. Are raccoon spirits coming towards us, or just...
They're just, like, scampering around doing raccoon things. One or two of them will stop for a minute and watch. One of them, like, goes like this and points at Thorfinn and then points down and then laughs some more, and the rest of them... But it's not the same laugh you heard before, Thorfinn. You don't even hear this laugh. And they scamper off.
Along with the raccoon.
You're gonna follow the raccoon?
No, I'm gonna sort of wolf chuckle.
Okay. This wolf looks like he wants to sneeze or something, Thorfinn.
Thorfinn does not give a fuck.
All right, what's Chase's the Storm doing?
Just mainly, rather than watching his surroundings, he's watching Thorfinn carefully.
All right. Well, he's nude and washing his clothes, and then I don't know what he does after that.
Nudeness doesn't really bother wolves, I don't think.
No, I'm just letting you know.
Yeah, we're good.
Then puts his clothes back on.
Yeah, he like dons his freezing cold, soaking wet clothes instantly, like a fucking Norwegian.
Just cold this for
when you get out and you're putting your clothes on, you notice the big red wolf is staring at you, and he says, "Ultimatum, white man, seem off."
He shrugs.
Teach you wrong. I teach better.
Now chases the Storm. Respect elders.
Have respect. Is strong fighter. Strong fighter in my tribe does not require fear.
Yes, but he is not of your tribe, or any of the pure tribes.
He looks over at Thorfinn. In your tribe, respect and fear must be one and same.
He nods somewhat. Respect his power. Respect his killing worm.
Yes. Respect skill. Do not need to fear warrior. He'll kind of like move his it's kind of like a weird motion, but he just kind of moves his head from side to side. Must teach to find center. Inside heart to lock rage and master it and not be master.
He is not.
And when he says that, pins the hair, slaps you on like the left side of your chest. Heart is there. Start there. Now you know where to look.
He nuts one more time. Kind of bowing his head in shame.
Let me roll an empathy really quick.
Cool. You roll your empathy. We are young. will make mistake and fail.
Alright, so I got plenty of successes. Do not feel shame. And he, like, looks over at the other two Lupuses who probably, like, don't like me talking like this. But, do not feel shame. Our warrior of Gaia, our rage of Gaia, have most rage. Only shame in not learning. Only killed worm-tainted men, correct?
Not.
Good. Not so different from us.
Did not eat man.
One more time.
He looks at you and says, did not eat man?
He just says, no, did not.
Good.
Wendigo sometimes eat heart of enemy.
Younger brother custom is not custom of older brother.
Not good for Guru to do this, but Wendigo himself does this. Wendigo is warrior, rules with respect and fear. More fear.
Chew, don't swallow.
Thorfinn.
Hi.
What have you to add? Must communicate with brothers to forge strong bond. Actually, must hunt to form strong bond.
I look up in the sky. What time is it?
It's starting to be. It's like about to be. Or the sun is starting to set. The sky is all red and starting to turn purple off to one side.
He looks up to the sky and says, change will happen soon.
Yes, yes. Soon we'll be changed, be better hunter. But tonight we hunt.
This time is good for hunter.
He nods. Sure.
All right.
And I don't know, but what time does the dress change? Like, as quick as the moon gets up, or...?
Yeah, once the moon's fully over the horizon and you can see the full thing, you'll change.
Cool.
How many years of...
It's winter time.
Alright, so that would probably be pretty early then.
Yeah, it's sunset already. You guys weren't that... You weren't gone that long. Couple of hours.
And the same, the moon usually comes up before the sun goes down, actually.
Oh, really?
Or in air. Yeah.
Okay, cool. Oh, so, yeah. Like, you start to see the moon, like, peeking over the horizon. It's about, like, a quarter of the way up. And you start feeling a distinct rustling in your jimmies.
So my jimmies are rustled. And yeah,
well,
I do the shake.
They're getting rustled.
He nods, and... He looks to the others. Brothers, my change is coming upon me.
I just cock my head to the side.
That's exactly what I do.
Explain.
Uncontrollable change at the full moon.
Become what?
To become warrior Kurinos.
Not good for hunting.
Bite off large chunk. Maybe cannot chew. Face of the storm. Chew, not swallow.
Chase's storm. Hits like his head droops down, and there's like a short like series of like nods.
So yeah,
go berserk when change.
He shakes his head. Just change.
Cannot ignore.
The moon calls for change.
Moon calls, but will may be stronger.
He'll look at the other Arun, Robert's character, who I think is like something friends with bears or something.
Frozen Pelt, friends with bears.
Okay.
Friends of bear. Friend of bears. There we go. Friend of bears.
Oh. Maybe Arun's lead scout, and we take patrol this night instead of hunt.
We'll patrol other side if you patrol this side.
Agree. Chase's storm is very fluid, so if you see things, I will help.
You will hear my howl.
Mm.
Thorfinn. Gaze into water.
It looks into the water.
Now do as I do. I, like, come up next to you, gaze into the water, and, I gotta roll Gnosis. And I pass. Three successes. I step sideways into the umbra.
Cool.
So if you want to do the same, just roll Gnosis, difficulty 5.
How do I get that dice thing to come up on my screen?
On the left-hand side, there's a yellow circle with two dice in it. It says Dice Stream. You just click on that, and it'll pop up on the right.
Oh,
yeah. Unless you're lagging, or it decides not to.
Yeah, sometimes it makes your ship crash.
Yeah.
Okay, so you succeed. Both step through into the umbra.
Oh, there we go.
Can change here. No one will care.
Yeah. So I guess at that point, like, Thorfinn will begin to more or less change. He'll go into his Krenos form with this big, like, white, grayish wolf with some scars upon him. The most noticeably the one on his throat from the 45 caliber slug.
Shines brighter on this side. Alright, back to Zig, who is patrolling the noise.
That's right. I'm looking for the sound, or just generally looking into the outside, just to see if there's anyone spying on us.
Yeah, roll a perception survival.
Oh, right. I'll spend a willpower point on this one before I roll. Right. Perception of 4, survival 1. There we go. Look at these successes. I don't know what the difficulty is, but I got 4 willpower.
Okay. So you notice 2 sets of bare human footprints. Basically at the tree line leading back towards town.
Ooh. I will turn into wolf so I run faster and follow the footprints.
Alright, are you trying to be... What are you trying to do? Like, track them down?
Yeah.
Alright, so with that...
Hopefully intercepting them before they get to town, because I'm not going into town.
Alright. With those successes, you're able to track them, and You track them basically almost all the way back to the Fianna Bar, and as you, like, hit the tree line, you see there's two black dudes in red, like, prospector pajamas with overalls on over them. They each have, like, a jug in one hand, and they have the other arm around the other one. They're, like, exactly the same height and look very similar, although you can only see them from the back. And all black people look the same. Just kidding.
From behind, they do.
They have the same haircut and everything. They're just, like, they're snickering that same little...
I'll turn to, human form and approach them both from behind.
Okay.
And I'll say in Native American, how are you?
Oh! Oh my God, Timothy! It's a goddamn engine! Get the scatter gun!
I'll raise the hand and I'll make a primal or urge roll to see if I can figure out if these guys are my bros or not.
Okay.
Bros of me. There we go. Three successes?
Yeah. They are... They're not regular humans. They have some sort of animalistic qualities, but you're having a hard time putting your hand on it. I mean, your finger on it. Like, there's some kind of...
Paw.
All right, As I'm eyeing them, I'll, like, look quite confused, visibly. And, as
oh,
I have...
Oh, no! He's trying to put one of those engine hexes on us! He's gonna steal our souls! Beat it!
And they both, like...
Is there a common name for the rock, for the place we just came from?
Not for outsiders.
Okay. I will just...
Call them the rock.
Yeah, I'll gesture to the tracks and point to them, and point back, and do like a sign for rock. Try to like verbally non-verbally communicate. Oh, these guys.
You thought we'd be bigger?
Uh-huh.
Oh no, he's put the hex on us.
Listen,
mister, we don't want any trouble.
I'll eye them. Do these jugs look similar to the ones that were brought back?
No, they're big, like, earthenware jugs with, like, three X's on them. In, like, black chalk or whatever the fuck, black paint.
Mm-hmm. I'll,
They smell like alcohol.
Smell like alcohol. All right.
Just so you know, Jake, I will occasionally be doing, like, perception occult to sense worm while we're out patrolling.
Okay, fair enough. If you want to roll that right now, that would be cool.
Can you roll for me?
Five dice.
Five dice.
Okay. All right, so what are you doing, Zig?
I'm going to I'm going to use, Uncloak the Hidden on these guys just to see what I can, you know, supernaturally uncover about these bros.
Alright, hold on, I need to look that up. Unless you have it up, like, what does it do?
Perception plus investigation difficulty 8, it just tells me if they're hiding stuff. It just basically tells me if they're hiding stuff. That's all it does.
Hiding stuff in what manner?
Spot disguises, concealed weapons, things like that. So if they stole something and they're hiding it, I could figure out if they stole something.
And as for sense worm, based on distance and relative power of it, would increase the difficulty.
Alright. There's nothing super powerful of the worm like in the cairn.
Well, yeah, I'm not doing it in the cairn. I'm, like, doing it when we're out on patrol.
Okay. How many successes did you get, Z?
Haven't rolled yet, so that's a perception plus investigation, I believe, and I got an investigation. Five dice, double the 8, I got one success.
Okay. These dudes are some kind of Fera.
Okay. Out of character, what the hell's a Fera?
Like a werebeast.
Okay. Do I know if the werebeasts speak the same language as us or no?
They don't really.
Alright. If I know they're a pharaoh, I will say in mother's tongue or whatever, I'll say, what were you doing back there? I have followed your tracks to this location. And I'm looking a little annoyed at these two.
They look like very confused at one another. Please, mister, we don't have any money. We was just getting drunk in the woods. We don't want to bother nobody no how. We're just poor, simple prospectors.
I even though I'm Hamid, I'll give him like a, you know, a very slight growl, like, and I'll walk back away from these guys, but keeping my eye on them. Never interacted with whatever the hell that these guys are, but don't want to turn my back to them either.
Oh, we're sorry. We'll get out of here right away. Get out of your way, Mr. Injured Man. You can hunt all the deer you want. Tell you what, I'm just going to leave this. I'm going to leave this here jug of moonshine here. You can have it if you want to. And puts it down on the floor, and they both, like, start backing away.
All right. Here's what I'm going to do. Once they're gone, I don't want to take too much time, but once they're gone, I'm going to try to step sideways and follow these guys. Because if there's werewolves, right, or something, yeah. I can follow.
All right, so roll the gauntlet is 6 here.
I'll spend a willpower point. All
right.
And I succeed with 1 success, the willpower point.
You step through.
All right, I follow these guys.
All right. Chris. You were looking for a rock to smash or a tree to rip up.
Or just something. Or, like, if I come across any game, like, I'm probably going to kill them.
Okay. So you're walking around all pissed in the woods trying to find this, like, something to fuck up. And all of a sudden you step in something, like, cold and sticky. And all of a sudden the scent of crabs fills your nostrils.
Well, great. I don't get a perception roll or anything, huh?
Yeah, I guess. If you really don't want to step in something cold and sticky.
I don't like imitation crab meat.
Alright. Well, I mean, it's actually bona fide crab meat, but most of it's been picked from the carcasses already.
Alright. So, I get 1 success.
Alright, you just stop short of stepping in a pool of, colored liquid that just kind of basically surrounds the entire one side of this J-Oak, and there's a bag of, like, crabs that has been picked at by, like, a human or a Garu, and then some raccoons.
I, like, bury it under dirt because it's nasty. It's not wormy, is it?
No. Except maybe, like, actual real worms, not, like, the worm.
Yeah, well, I'm just going to, like, bury it under dirt so, like, I don't step in it again.
Alright, so you flick some dirt around or whatever, you bury the sack of crabs, and you generally cover this, like, pools of stuff on the floor.
I guess what I'm going to do is, since I'm so pissed, I'm going to, like, just shift into lupus and maybe go kill a deer or something.
Alright.
And hunt. By myself.
To roll a perception survival, I guess. Or wits survival. Whatever's higher.
Difficult. Oh, it's perception's higher. Alright. They're so pretty close.
By the way, PJ,
even in wolf form?
Oh, yeah, well, minus the whatever. Like, if difficulty 6, if it's in wolf form, do the minus difficulty thing.
Now I'm confused, but I get 1 success, so I find, like, a squirrel.
You have more than 1 success.
It's difficulty 4 if you're on this, right?
4? Then, I get 2 successes.
Okay. Alright, so you managed to track down a deer.
All right. Yeah, I'm going to.
It's like drinking a pool in the ground.
I'm going to try to, like, get up on it as close as possible. And, like, just, as wolves do, like, grab it around the neck.
All right, so do a dex stealth.
Dex stealth. Let's see, I get 2 stealth in wolf form, right? In lupus?
I don't know.
I think so.
Okay.
I've got the chart here.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, lupus, dexterity, +2, strength, +1, stamina, +2.
Yeah.
So I'd say dex stealth. So.
Yes, please.
Difficulty 6?
Yep.
2 successes.
Alright, you're pretty stealthy. You can roll an attack.
Okay.
If you hit, you're just going to take it down, basically.
Is that brawl?
Yeah.
Alright, so... It's difficulty 5.
Because you're...
1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, yeah. You
4 to bite, so...
You bring it down to the ground and you kill it. PJ, with your sense worm roll, after about like 3 hours of, you know, patrolling or whatever, you come across the scent of the worm pretty strongly. You notice it's coming from it's not exactly a cave. It's like a dug-in part of like a rock wall face that doesn't have like a network of caves behind it. It's just like an indented like caveman cave. And it's really dark in there. But something smells like the worm coming from in there. Yeah. You're muted if you're trying to talk.
I will slow down and I will move over to Robert's character and I will point my nose at the cave and say, "Worm there."
Strong scent. Strong scent.
Yeah.
Jake, how many are with us right now?
Just you and PJ, and possibly Pins the Hair in the Umbra, but maybe not.
Be back. I'm going to make a note to scroll into the Umbra really quick.
Okay, go ahead. Gauntlet's 5.
Huh?
The gauntlet is 5.
5? I think I got it.
Yep.
Yeah.
So yeah, you step into the Umbra.
I'm gonna look around for Pins the Hair and the other guru. All
right. Let's see. I'm gonna roll a chance die, I guess. You don't want a 6 or anything over 4, basically. If you get a 5 or a 6, he's not around. Oh, there's a 4. All right, so yeah, they're in the Umbra close by. Not, like, directly next to you, but pretty close by.
Can I catch Pins the Hair's attention without making noise?
Yeah, because you have, like, a strong presence in the Umbra. So he looks over, and he notices the familiar, like, fuckery that is your dude in the Umbra.
Thorvin sees a wolf, forget exactly how you worded it before, let me bring it up.
Okay.
Thorvin, you see a wolf wreathed in an icy mist, whose fur looks as if it's coated in frost.
Right.
And my eyes, instead of the eyes that you see normally, are glowing blue.
Huh. Okay. Well, it's the Umbra, so shit happens. And yeah, Thorfinn is not in his homage form either. He's in his Krenos form.
And my lupus form. I cock my head over at you and start to walk over.
He's gonna motion to the cave. And then jump out of the Umbra.
Alright, time to jump out of the Umbra.
Same difficulty?
Yep. Yeah, Thorfinn, roll your Gnosis difficulty 5. Don't botch.
There we go. That's better.
What'd you get, Thorfinn? You're muted.
I failed.
Okay. Alright, so basically, Pins the Hare and this other wolf seamlessly jump out of the Umbra, and you, like, go to try to follow them, and you just, like, hop a little bit and land, and you're still in the Umbra.
Can I try it again?
Yeah, you can.
You can do it.
There we go.
Except it doesn't work in the same place twice if you fail. You have to go elsewhere.
Which means take the 5-foot step and retry.
Yeah.
I think it has to be farther than 5 steps.
How long is far further?
You gotta go, like, out of the sight of this cave.
Yeah, yeah. But basically I know where the cave is anyway.
Yes.
So I make a little loop, jump out another spot, and
you try to... Yeah. With that roll. Alright. So you pop out, and then just give me a wits survival difficulty 5.
Cool.
Alright, cool. So you're able to easily find your way back to the cave.
Yeah. So this big Krenos approaches from a little farther away. And you can see that it is Thorfinn in all his glory.
And Pins kind of like winces as you like are making noise coming towards us.
And he gets more stealthy, I guess.
Alright, roll a dex stealth, I guess. Difficulty 7, because you're in Krenos.
So that's a... Of course. I get one success, but I get 1-1, so fucking fail.
It was difficulty 7.
Oh, then 2. One success.
Okay. You're a little more quiet. You're at least not crunching branches and shit. You're picking where you're stepping. What are the Aruns doing? Because they're obviously leading this charge. I'm a fucking Theurge.
Yeah, I'm actually going to shift to Hispo.
Okay.
Hispo.
Alright. I'm going to do the same because I want to be part of the pack.
And I'm going to, as we walk, I'm going to activate Razor Claws.
Me too.
I don't have that, so you guys start scratching the floor and I feel bad about myself.
Teach you later.
I don't do it. You still have me. So, can I talk in Krenos?
Yeah. You can speak in mother's tongue.
Cool. He looks at the three of you and asks, what happened?
I quietly...
I look at you like you're nuts when you start talking.
I'm not talking, I'm more whispering.
Whispering, and Krynos is like,
yeah, instead of being like, oh my god, it's like, oh my god. You still fucking hear it.
Whatever you do, don't tell him there's any worm there.
So, I kind of...
It stinks like the worm outside this cave.
Okay.
I open and close my mouth, and then turn around.
Okay.
I am also going to spend a Gnosis to activate Heightened Senses.
Alright.
And I'm going to go ahead and go into the cave.
Right. Let's go. Let's do this. Anybody got pack tactics?
No.
Hell no.
I can't have all the things.
Yeah.
No one got time for that shit.
Three runes here and nobody's got pack tactics. Beautiful. Alright.
What is that, actually?
It's a rune gift that lets you coordinate an attack and get bonus dice. Everybody gets bonus dice.
All the dice. All the time.
I don't know. I just have... I might have it, actually. Wait, give me a second.
Alright. Well, I'm going to take up the back because I am a theurge.
And no one will seem to argue about that.
We'll protect the squishy.
I can fight, bro. I'm a wendigo, bro. Come at me. Don't come at me. You're in a rune, but come at me at anything else.
I challenge you to a drinking contest.
Alright, I accept your challenge, and since I'm accepting the challenge, I get to pick the terms, and we're going to drink worm taint.
Alright,
nice.
You go first. The honor is yours.
We go at the same time. I'm picking the...
1, 2, 3!
Right,
And then I don't, and I see if you do.
I take I one sip, I vomit it, and then I win. And you have to become my bitch.
Guys.
Do this fight, you guys. Do this fight.
Guys, I don't have pack tickets, but I have inspirations that I can pop.
Pop that.
Do whatever you want to do. I don't want to hear this mechanics out of character bullshit. What are you guys doing?
I pop inspiration. You all gain one willpower. And
tell me what you're doing, bruh.
I point into the cave and kind of looks menacingly into the cave as I smell the worm, and I guess fucking lead the charge.
Oh, all right. Okay. I feel inspired. Let's go get that worm.
Worm, to Valhan. To Valhan, everyone.
What up, PJ?
Before I go in, I will take a peek at that full moon that's up in the sky, since it's actually like up and dark now after 3 hours, mm-hmm. and get that rage back.
All right, that I spent on my clothes.
Yep. And then I guess we're going ham.
All right. So Eric, you enter the cave, and it like fucking reeks like the worm. You don't see anything immediately. Just seems like a... Alright, so here's what you see, actually. It's like a dugout piece of like the rock wall. It looks like a good place for engines to make shelter. There are some bones on the floor that are not human. And also, there are three small fuzzy lumps in the back of the cave.
That's weird as shit. I'll wait for the others. Just take a minute, take a second and wait to see that everyone
Well, they're pretty
is...
much right behind you. This isn't a very large cave.
Okay, I'm going to look at the shapes.
Yep.
Are you getting closer to them or what?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
Moving in with some sort of caution.
Alright. Everybody roll perception alertness.
Okay.
I guess difficult six. I get zero.
Perception what, bro?
Alertness.
Okay. Can you roll me 4 dice, please?
Yes.
What's the difficulty?
6.
Okay, all of those are successes for me because I have heightened senses active.
Oh, right on. Okay.
I got 4 successes.
Okay, cool. Eric, you got none?
Nah.
Alright. Everybody except Eric, hears, very almost imperceptible shift of razor-sharp claws on rock coming from behind you. And then everyone should roll for initiative except for Eric.
Okay.
What do you roll for?
Wits plus dex. You roll a d10. And, yeah, you roll a... Sorry, you add your wits and dex to 1d10.
Can you roll that?
Nice. Should I roll and later add that, or should I roll that at a later date? Because I guess I am going to get into the fight sometime.
Yeah. So, yeah, I guess roll it, and then you're going to go last this turn, and then you'll go in your order the next turn.
Yeah, sure.
Sound good?
Yeah, cool. All right.
So I got 15. Let me roll for PJ. What am I adding, PJ?
10.
Alright, so you got 14.
I got 17.
Alright.
I got 11, but I'm lost in it.
Alright. Alright, cool. So... Rob, you see what may have at one time been a mountain lion. Now its eyes are like pupilless, green, luminous orbs sunken deep into its eye sockets. The flesh around its mouth and nose is receded to the point where you can kind of see bone. It has black stuff dripping out of its nose hole and mouth, and around its claws. It's got big open festering sores all over its body and long hangy, gross, dripping black nipples and a long tail, which has
hellhound
leaf shape, has a leaf shape thing at the back with a lamprey mouth in it.
Oh, okay. Can I kill it?
I don't fucking know, man. That's all to the dice.
No, I know, but that's all I care about. I'm going to leap at it.
Alright.
Fangs going, claws going for throat.
Alright, well, if you're going for a bite, it's difficulty 5. It's difficulty 6 if you're going for a claw, I think. Unless it's a 5 for both.
Let me see.
I'm pretty sure it's just diff 5 for bite in this build.
Hold on. So many things active at once.
I have a sheet somewhere.
Okay, here we go. Claw, yeah, it's difficulty 6. Bite is difficulty 5.
Which one are you doing?
I'm
spending rage.
I'm not going to spend rage this turn.
All right.
But I am leaping at it with both claws.
All right, right on.
One claw attack, but both claws. So.
Okay, roll a dex roll with your hispo stats. Oh, and make sure to hit clear on the dice thing to get rid of that die you already rolled.
Yep.
Hold on. My sheet's being difficult because I have, like, three things activated.
That's quite all right.
All right. So, a lot of successes.
I mean, if you roll them, yeah.
Yeah, okay, so I got, that gets rid of one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven successes.
I don't see any dice.
That's weird. I see them on my screen.
I will take your word for it. Okay, so a razor claws gives you something.
Minus one, plus two. In minus one difficulty, plus two in damage.
Plus two dice, or?
Plus two dice.
Plus two dice.
That's not what it says in front of me right here, but.
It's in the V20 anyway. The double V20.
Hold on. Why would it reduce the difficulty?
I don't know. One 171 razor claws. The player spends one rage point, and the arrow rune takes a full turn. All claw attacks do two additional dice of damage and are made at one minus one difficulty for the rest of the scene.
Huh, that's some bullshit. But all right. So go ahead and roll fucking your strength plus your successes plus two.
Strength plus successes plus two. The specialization come into play again?
If you roll tens, they're doubled.
Oh, okay. So strength plus number of successes.
Well, it's strength plus the number of successes minus one. And then you add two.
So plus one.
Because it's like each extra success gives you a plus one.
Right. So clear. Hold on.
What
I don't know why it's
though with that W20 razor claws. Like, oh yeah, it used to give you one additional die of damage. Now it's minus one difficulty and plus two damage, and it's rank one.
It's weird.
It doesn't make any sense. But all right.
It's weird.
That's bullshit. I'm going to revise that after this session.
They decided that lupus weren't deadly enough.
Yeah, with their fucking five everything.
I don't know why it's not showing.
You're a dirty, rotten fucking cheat. I believe you. Just tell me how many successes you got.
Alright, so I got three tens, a nine.
Six. Alright, listen, buddy. Yeah. Don't make me do math. Just count them up. The tens count twice.
The ten. Okay, so 6, 7, 8, 9. I got 10 successes.
All right, now I gotta roll for this fucking thing to sink. Okay, it soaks one. You fucking kill it.
Just like row.
Yeah, you swipe it and like you hit its throat and basically like it looks at you confused for a second and then its head falls from its neck and this black shit just sprays all up the cave walls and yeah.
All right.
Your claw is covered in this thick gross worm smelling stuff that itches. It's just basically, like, tainted blood. It's not gonna, like... You just have to cleanse yourself. It's not doing any damage or anything. Okay. Everybody else, this creature has been dealt with. I just kind of sit there and scratch myself.
That's what happens when you go with three Oruns into a cave. Oh, I'm a Theurge and three Oruns. Yeah, let's watch.
I'm totally fine with it. I don't really want to be fighting any kind of Shadow Panthers or whatever we're calling this thing. We're calling them Shadow Panthers now. But anyway, these cool. Three little lumps in the back of the cave that you guys were looking at before are three like mountain lion cubs. And they're really, really skinny. One of them is actually dead with black stuff coming out of its mouth. The other two are, like, shaky and skinny, and they smell slightly like the worm.
That's a dilemma. I'm going to look over at Pins the Hare. Can they be cleansed?
I'll try. If it doesn't work, then you know what you have to do. Try it. Alright. Watch my back in case there's any more fucking Shadow Panthers.
I will gently pick one up and take it and like drop it outside the cave so it's not trying to be cleansed in a tainted cave.
Good idea.
I will do the same with the other.
Alright, and I'll grab the dead one and I'll drag it out and toss it like next to, kind of a little off to the side of the other ones and, I'll start doing my rite of cleansing on them. Is there a role for that if it's like a serious thing, or is it just always you just do it?
Hold on.
My book.
That would be definitely something I look up.
Found it. Don't worry. Hold on.
Okay.
I have to spend a gnosis point. Each object beyond one, and I'm cleansing. And the difficulty equals the gnosis. Oh, it's one gnosis point. Oh, never mind. It says the rite can be cast upon more than one person or object, but the leader must spend one gnosis on each additional thing. So I gotta spend one gnosis. The difficulty level equals the gnosis of the spirit that inflicted the contagion, maximum of 10. I'm gonna say 7. Only one success is required. What the fuck am I rolling, though? Gnosis?
You're rolling, I believe you're rolling gnosis and rituals.
Yeah, I would say it's like something like that. Like, yeah, intelligence rituals or gnosis rituals or something like that.
I'm going to look up the start part of rituals.
I guess I'll do it makes sense to do intelligence rituals, so I'll do that.
Let's see, enacting a rite, yada yada yada.
Alright, I cleanse the fuck out of them. Oh, I have to spend 2 gnosis, actually, though. So I'm down to 5. Because I had to cleanse the body as well. Want to fight about it?
okay.
Yeah, so now they're cleansed, and you guys have 2 little panther cubs, or mountain lion cubs, without a mother, because their mother became worm-tainted somehow. The cave, in and of itself, PJ, actually, was not tainted. Only the blood on the walls and shit and the blood inside that panther lady and the dead cub were tainted.
So,
what kind of rite is it?
What?
What kind of rite is it? Accord, Cairn, Death, Mystic. Mystic is wits and rituals, it says on the chart.
I don't know, it doesn't say in this thing that I'm looking at.
I'm guessing it would be mystic.
Well, my intelligence and wits are both 3, so it's the same roll either way.
Cool.
Right. Success. Okay, so this would make like a good place to stay.
I agree.
Like outside of the cairn. So in character, I can ascertain that, Jake. Like, I can feel like it's from the blood, and if we were to cleanse this, like, we could make a nice place here.
Well, yeah, because, like, I don't know, when you go into the cave doesn't, like, have any scent of the worm itself, but this blood fucking reeks. Like, it seems to be this black shit that is what is tainted. Because even now, like, the dead body of this thing, like, it reduces to, like, black ichor. And okay. That's what stinks.
Okay. And approximately how many of us does it look like could stay in here comfortably? If we were, like, say in Lupus. 4?
Yeah.
Okay. And is this, like, rock, or is this just, like, hardened, like, dirt and clay, or what?
The floor is hardened dirt and clay, and the walls and ceiling are rock.
Okay.
And it has, like, a little overhang of, like, vines or something coming over the front.
Oh, that's nice.
But not completely covering it, like, about halfway.
Okay.
So it would shield you from the sun and, like, some rain, but, like, people could still look. If they were looking straight on, they could still see into it.
But if we did, like, some rites and some cool stuff, we could probably make it a cooler place.
Probably, that's but fine. I don't have those rites.
Make it bigger on the inside?
Yes, well, yeah. Hard to see. Right. I think that's a pretty good spot to end.
Go find a bone gnar.
I'm going to end the broadcast.